Hey, want some tips to optimize your chance for pregnancy with Clomid and IUI? Stay tuned. Clomid combined with IUI is a common method used by fertility experts to improve the chances for pregnancy in couples with unexplained infertility. We know that Clomid can improve the chance for pregnancy by increasing the number of eggs that are released, and IUI can increase the chance for pregnancy by increasing the number of sperm that reach the fallopian tubes. IUI requires precise timing, however. The best pregnancy rates are produced when the insemination is done on the day of ovulation. One of the ways in which doctors will monitor Clomid cycles is with blood tests and ultrasound. Eggs are located inside tiny cysts called follicles. As an egg matures, the follicle grows larger. This can be seen and measured on ultrasound. When a doctor thinks the eggs are mature, the eggs can be released from the ovary with a one-time injection of a medication called HCG. This is known as triggering ovulation. This is a very accurate way to determine the timing for IUI, since we know that ovulation occurs about 36 hours after a woman receives the trigger injection. What is the best time to trigger ovulation? Should it be done when the follicles are smaller? Some doctors think this is best. They worry that the quality of the eggs from larger follicles might be compromised by waiting too long. Other doctors worry that by triggering ovulation earlier, it might result in the release of immature eggs that won't be able to be fertilized. Recently, a study was done that helps us to answer this question. Doctors looked at about 1,700 Clomid cycles that had ovulation triggered with HCG and pregnancy was attempted with IUI. They compared the pregnancy rates based on how big the largest follicle measured on ultrasound was when HCG was given. The pregnant and non-pregnant groups were otherwise very similar. What did the results show? When the largest follicle measured between 17 and 20 millimeters, the pregnancy rate was about 8%. Between 20 and 21 millimeters, the pregnancy rate was about 11%. However, when the largest follicle was over 21 millimeters, the pregnancy rate was about 16%. It isn't always possible to get a follicle that big, however. Sometimes a woman's body will trigger ovulation on its own when the follicle is smaller. Other times, the follicles reach a plateau or even start to decrease in size. This does not mean that other factors don't impact the chance for Clomid IUI success. A woman's age, weight, infertility diagnosis, and her partner's sperm numbers can also affect Clomid pregnancy rates. However, all other things being equal, larger follicles produce more pregnancies than smaller ones. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.